Hey there guys, was really looking forward to seeing the Blackening once I saw the trailer. It basically makes fun of the cliche that a black character always dies in a horror film, which of course isn't true. House on Haunted Hill, Dawn of the Dead, Get Out, Deep Blue Sea, Anaconda, Urban Legend Final Cut, and I Still Know What You Did Last Summer, all have black characters surviving, and there's many more too. So the story sees a group of friends spending the weekend away in a remote cabin for a reunion. However, there's a killer at large who traps them inside, forcing them to play this ball game. The group must work together answering the questions in order to survive. I really enjoyed The Blackening. Bodies, Bodies, Bodies was a disappointing horror comedy, which involved playing a game. It's a bit similar in the setup. However, The Blackening has better written characters and progression of the plot. This film relies on the characters, and I loved how different they all are to each other. They all do different things. The maturity is different levels, and I liked what each one brought to the table. So, there's seven main friends. You got Allison, played by Grace Byers. She's there for a good time, no drama. She gets singled out sometimes because she's mixed race. Lisa, played by Antoinette Robinson. She's hiding the secret that she's back with her ex. Namdi, played by Signora Waltz, is the ex in question. Dwayne, played by Dwayne Perkins, who is protective of Lisa because of the cheating Namdi did while seeing Lisa. King, played by Melvin Gregg, is viewed as the gangster of the group. Shaniqua, played by ex-Mayo, is the wildcat of the group. And Clifton, played by Jermaine Forler, is the nerdy one. The pacing is fantastic. It gets straight into it. The opening scene is really good with two really, really funny moments, and it carries it on from there. There are some moments of truce in the story involving Dwayne and Lisa falling out over Namdi, but that doesn't slow it down, and the conflict is a good part to have. The killer looks good, the crossbow is a nice touch, something different, and it makes not the best decision, which leads to firmly good comedy, and I liked how it played out really. I'm going to give The Blackening an 8 out of 10. Really great set of characters and a great story. I feel like they could have revealed the killer a bit better, but that's my only criticism. It's a really entertaining flick, and keeps that way until the end credits. I just want to talk a bit about what happens in the film, so these are spoilers, you have been warned. If you told me that none of the protagonists gets killed, I'd have thought it wouldn't have been that entertaining, but they made the right decision. The characters are so great individually that none of them become expendable. It would have been a shame if anyone got killed, so I'm glad they made it through. Now, I feel like they missed a chance for a good running joke. When the group first come face to face with a killer, King gets shot with an arrow. They manage to get away, then he gets shot again when the killer finds him. I think it would have been funner if King got shot a third time and he could have said something like, "Why am I the only one getting shot?" or "That's the last time you stick an arrow in me." I'm going to wrap it up there. Hopefully you enjoyed The Blackening as much as I did. Take care.